Hey guys, Cassie Davis here, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm gonna talk to you guys about 5 tips that I use to stay motivated. Let's get to it. Tip number 1 is learn to control your mindset. I did a whole video before on mindset and how simply changing your negative thoughts into positive ones can really change your whole life. So definitely make sure to check that video out. Once you're able to control your mindset and the thoughts that are going on in your head, you're able to better control your motivation as well. We speak to ourselves more than anyone else does on this planet, so you really have to make sure that you're saying the right things in your head. A lot of times we have negative thoughts, and simply changing those thoughts to positive ones can really make the world of a difference. If you notice yourself saying negative thoughts, like, I really don't feel like doing this, I'm so tired, whatever it may be, just realize that and stop it and tell yourself, no, Cassie, or insert name there. No, I got this. I could do this. I'm not tired. I'm motivated. I'm ready. When you continue saying positive thoughts in your head versus the negative ones, your actions will follow. For tip number 2, realize that life has its ups and downs. Nothing's always gonna be an upward path. Things are always gonna be cyclical. It's always gonna go up and down. Like, life is up and down, and motivation is cyclical as well too. It goes up and down. Sometimes you're really motivated and you're on a path and you're going up, but then you hit a wall and, you know, you're tired or you're worn out, or someone said something to you that pissed you off and now you feel insecure or you feel unmotivated. And you have to realize that. I think tip number 2 is really realizing that life isn't always gonna be an upward path. There's gonna be ups and downs. And once you learn to realize that you have those ups and downs, you're better able to allow yourself to deal with those emotions of the downs in order to get yourself back up to moving to the highs. You know, like I mentioned, life has its ups and downs, and especially for women, a lot of our ups and downs are controlled by our hormonal cycle. You know, we have a lot of emotions when we're close to getting our periods, and that's just what it is. So a lot of times, I find myself a little unmotivated around that time, you know? So I feel like the hormones definitely play a role in our bodies and a role in that cycle of ups and downs. So definitely just make sure to be aware that nothing's gonna ever be perfect. You're always gonna have highs and you're always gonna have lows. So once you learn to sort of deal with those lows and learn a process of like coping and moving forward and, you know, changing those negative thoughts into positive ones, then your life becomes more of a balance of maybe you go into lows, but you're able to get yourself out quicker and you're able to constantly push yourself, be going in those highs. Make sure to give yourself breaks when you need them to deal with your emotions and cope with your emotions. However, also realize that time is precious and that the more time you spend being productive and being positive, the closer and faster you'll get to your goals. Which leads me to tip number 3, set goals for yourself. Your goals should be specific and measurable. So for example, say you want to grow your following on social media. That shouldn't be your goal. You should tell yourself how much you want to grow your following and by when you want to grow your following. You know, give yourself a number and a time frame. Make sure they're very specific so that way you can really work towards achieving those goals and make sure you're actually taking actions to get yourself there. Also, aside from making sure your goals are specific and measurable, also make sure you're taking actions every day at reaching those goals. Create the steps it takes to get you to those goals. So if we're going back to the example of growing your social media following, steps to get you to those goals of growing your following would be to post every day. And in order to post every day, you have to have content to post. So taking more pictures or setting days during the week where you're going to take pictures or make videos or edit video or whatever you need to do to make sure you always constantly have content to post every single day. My 4th tip on staying motivated, which goes hand in hand with setting goals, is writing lists. I feel like writing lists is really important, and I feel like when I write lists, I'm the most productive, and when I'm the most productive, I'm the most motivated. So I feel like productivity and motivation go really hand in hand. When you feel like you're productive, you feel like yourself going on that upward hill, and you feel like, you know, life is going great, you're getting so much accomplished, and as you continue to be productive, you continue to be more and more motivated to do more and more and work harder and harder towards your goals. Like I mentioned, once you have your goals written down, you really have to start writing down the steps that it's going to take to get you to those goals. And in order to do that, you have to write lists. And I feel like when you have lists written down in front of you, specifically for me, I personally like having a handwritten list. I don't like using the computer because I personally feel like documents on the computer get all over the place. I'm not very organized when it comes to my computer. I have like a million, I'm that person that has like a million emails still not deleted and a million documents on my desktop, a million screenshots on my desktop. So when it comes to my computer, it's not very organized. To be honest, like, neither is my like day-to-day life or house either, but you know, having that list right there sitting next to me every single day that I can see, that I can open up to, I have a book that I constantly write lists in. So maybe get yourself like a notebook to write all your lists in, and write a list every single day if you have to, or refer back to the last day and see what you weren't able to accomplish that day and what you can work towards today. You know, and make sure you're crossing things off your list, because that really makes you feel accomplished and also makes you feel productive, which in turn makes you feel more motivated. So definitely make sure you're taking a pen and like striking through those lists, because it really mentally makes you feel like I'm getting done. When I make lists, I feel like that's the time frame in my life when I'm the most productive. And when I'm the most productive, I definitely feel the most motivated. So like I mentioned, I feel like productivity and motivation go hand in hand, and I feel like in order to feel motivated, you need to feel productive, and in order to be productive, I feel like lists is a great way. My fifth and last but not least tip is always keep pushing forward and stay consistent. Like I always say, consistency is key. To be honest with you guys, there's a ton of goals that I have in life that I have yet to accomplish. Honestly, no matter where you are in life, even if it's people you look up to, they still have goals that they have yet to accomplish. I mean, let's be honest, we're never really fully satisfied. There's always something, whether it be in career or relationship or health and beauty, there's always something that is a goal that we need to accomplish. And I feel like that idea of constantly progressing to be a better person, or be, you know, more fit or smarter or whatever you may be working towards, you know, you always are going to have goals in life, and regardless if you accomplish those goals, you're gonna have more goals. Of course, we look up and we see people in places where we feel like maybe I should be there, or why am I working so hard and I'm not getting there yet? Well, that's gonna happen. You have to trust your timing and what's meant for you, and you have to keep pushing forward and stay consistent. I feel like consistency is key, and I really mean that. Even if you feel like you aren't where you should be, just keep pushing forward. Every day, look at your lists. Every day, cross things off, and every day, work towards your goals. I feel like if you constantly are working towards your goals, you will get there eventually. No matter how long it takes you, you guys have the ability to get whatever you want in life, as long as you keep a positive mindset and stay consistent at working towards your goals. I believe in you guys, but you guys need to believe in yourselves. You need to work on creating a positive mindset, surround yourself with positive influences, set goals, write lists, do all the above, stay consistent, and realize that it's not always gonna be an uphill battle. It's gonna be ups and downs. And once you realize those things and constantly work every day at trying to, you know, make sure your mindset is right, surround yourself with positive people, and stay productive, you'll be more motivated more often. So that's it. Those are my five tips on how I stay motivated. Definitely make sure to check out my other video on mindset as well too. I talk a lot about positivity, surrounding yourself with positive influences, a lot of things that you can do to really help change your mindset, and how mindset has such a big impact on our lives. Like I had mentioned, we speak to ourselves more than anyone in this world, so we really have to make sure we're saying the right things. If we love ourselves, that's the only way that we're able to sort of love others and accept others. You know, if we're insecure with ourselves, or if someone is insecure with themselves, how can they, if they don't love themselves, how can they love somebody else? So, you know, self-love is really important. Mindset is really important. So definitely make sure to go check out that video. What do you guys think? Definitely make sure to leave some comments below. Let me know some tips that you use to stay motivated. If you like the video, please make sure to hit the like button below. If you haven't yet done so, please make sure to also subscribe to my channel. I have a ton of great more things coming your way that you don't want to miss out on. Like I mentioned before, I'll be posting every Wednesday at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, so make sure to tune in, and I'll see you guys next week.